بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، today بإذن الله continuing from Brother Shaib's lesson is on the 20th sitting and we're going في أسباب النصر الحقيقية. So the means of true victory or success. So here the Sheikh begins with الحمد لله العظيم في قدره العزيز في قهره العالم بحال العبد في سره وجهره الجائد على مجاهد على مجاهد بنصره وعلى متوادئ من أجله برفعه يسمع صريف القلم عند خط سطره ويرى النمل يدب في فيافي كفره ومن آياته أن تقوم السماء والأرض بأمره أحمده على قضاء حلوه ومره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقامة لذكره وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث بالبر إلى الخلق في البر في بره وبحره صلى الله عليه وعلى صاحب أبي بكر السابق مما وقر من الإيمان في صدره وعلى أمر مؤز الإسلام بحزمه وقهره وعلى عثمان ذي نورين الصابر من أمره على مره وعلى علي بن عمه و سهره وعلى آله أصحابه وتابعين لهم بإحسان ما جاد الساهب بقتره وسلم تسليما وسلم تسليما. So here the just the introduction which the Sheikh Al-Mubarak likes to رحمه الله like to start with, and he starts with all praises belongs to Allah, the great the one who's in his ability, in his the great one in his ability, the one whose status is magnificent, the mighty in his omnipotence, and the knower of the slave secrets, one affairs and the one that are open, and the one who is kind towards whoever strives in his cause by assisting him, and he is generous towards the one who humbles himself for the sake of Allah by elevating him. He hears the squeaking of the pen upon when one is writing with it, and he sees the crawling of the ant on a desert land, and from among his sign is the standing of the heaven and the earth by his command, and I praise him for his decree, both the good and the bad. And I further bear witness that none has a right to be worshipped in truth except Allah alone without any partners. And I also bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger who was sent with goodness to the creatures. May the peace on, so in the basically in the land and in the sea, may the peace of Allah be upon him. His companion Abu Bakr, the one who surpassed the Ummah after the Prophet with his faith, which settled in his heart. Upon Umar, the one who elevated al-Islam with his strong determination and strength. And upon Uthman, the owner of the two lights, meaning the two daughters of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he was married to, and the one who was patient with his affair, meaning that he was killed as well, and the oppression that he went through, although it was bitter. And upon Ali, the son-in-law of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and upon his family members, his companions and those who follow the steps in a good manner, as long as the cloud continues to shower his generosity. So there, after the introduction, the Sheikh he says, إخواني لقد نصر الله المؤمنين في مواتن كثيرة في بدر والأحزاب والفتح وحنين وغيرها نصرهم الله وفاء بوعده وكان حقا علينا نصر المؤمنين. So here the Sheikh begins, he says, my brothers, indeed Allah, He gave victory to the believers in many, many times and places. In Badr, the Battle of Badr that we went previously, we mentioned that. Battle of Ahzab is another battle. Confederates and the Battle of Fath, with Brother Shai mentioned yesterday, was a conquest of Mecca, and Hunain was another battle. And other than that, Allah aided them, gave victory to them, in fulfilling the promise, His promise, whereby Allah mentioned in the Quran, He said, "Wakana haqqan alayna," and it was certainly incumbent upon us to help the believers, Surah Ar-Rum. So then he mentioned also, "Inna lanansuru rusulana walladhina amanu fil hayati ad-dunya wa yawma yaqumul ashhad yawma la yanfa'u adh-dhalimina ma'dhiratuhum wa lahum al-la'natu wa lahum su'u ad-dar." Surah Ghafir, where Allah says, so he said, "Most surely we help our messenger and those who believe both in the present life and on the day when the witness will stand forth, the day when their pleading will not profit the wrongdoers, and for them will be the curse, and for them will be the evil abode," which is the hellfire. So Nasr, so then the Sheikh said, "Nasarahum Allah li'annahum qa'imuna bid-dinihi وهو الظاهر على أديان كله فمن تمسك به فهو ظاهر على الأمم كلها." Then Allah mentions, it mentions the ayah of Allah, "هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون." Surah Tawbah, verse 33. So we just mentioned that now. So here the Sheikh mentions that Allah gave victory to them because they established their religion, and the religion is victorious upon all the rest of the religions. So whoever sticks and clings to that religion, and then he is victorious over all the other nations, all of them combined. So then the Sheikh, he mentions the ayah of Surah Tawbah, where he mentions Huwa Allazi, and it mentions here, let me just get that, Surah Tawbah. So here, sorry, it's Surah Tawbah. Yeah, so here he mentions he is the one who sent his messenger with guidance and then and the religion of truth, and made it apparent over all religions, even if the polity is hated. So that is the proof for that, that the religion is superior than any other religions, even if the polity is and disbelievers hate it. نصرهم الله تعالى لأنهم قاموا بأسباب النصر الحقيقية المادية منها والمعنوية فكان عندهم من الأزم ما برزوا به على أعدائهم أخذا بتوجيه الله تعالى لهم وتمشيا مع حده وتثبيته إياهم. So then here the Sheikh mentions that Allah aided them because they were firm upon his religion, which is victorious over all the other religions. Therefore, whoever holds on to this religion will be victorious over all the nations, as Allah the Most High said. We mentioned that before. And then, so he said, Allah helped them only because they had taken the true means of victory, the material form, as well as the immaterial form. So someone said the physical forms and the spiritual forms, and then they had that determination, they had that the strong determination with which they overcame the enemies, implementing the instructions of Allah and walking with his guidance and with the stability that is given to them by Allah the Most High, as he the Most High said, we're going to read that. And he said, "Wala, wala tahinu, wala tahzanu, wa antumul a'launa in kuntum mu'minin. In yamsaskum karhum faqad massa al-qawma karhum mithluhu. Wa tilka al-ayyamu nudawiluha bayna an-nas." And then he also mentioned, "Wala tahinu fi ibtiqa'i al-qawm in takunu ta'lamuna fa innahum ya'lamuna kama ta'lamun wa tarjuna min Allahi ma la yarjun wa kana Allahu aliman hakima." And it also mentions, "Fala tahinu wa tad'u ila salbi wa antum al-a'launa wallahu ma'akum walan yatirukum a'malukum innama al-hayat ad-dunya la'ibun wa lahu." So here we just translate these ayahs. We just find the translation here. So he said, just get that. So the first one, so B. So he said here, let's check that. Surah Al-Imran. Surah Al-Imran. Wala tahinu. So here it said, "Wala tahinu wala tahzanu." Okay, I've got it here. So it's like a nor grieve, and you shall certainly have the upper hand if you are true believers. If you have received an injury, surely the disbelieving people have already received an injury, a similar injury. And such days we cause to alternate among men. And slacken not in seeking these people. If you suffer, they too suffer, even as you suffer, but you hope from Allah what they hope not, and Allah is all-knowing, all-wise. And he said, so be not slack and sue not for peace, for you will certainly have the upper hand, and Allah is with you, and he will not deprive you of the reward of your actions. So then the Sheikh, he says, فَكَانُوا بِحَادِهِ التَّقْوِيَ وَتَثْبِيتِ يصيرون بقوة وعزم وجد وأخذوا بكل نصيب من القوة امتثالا لقول ربهم سبحانه وتعالى وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة نفسية الباطنة والقوة العسكرية الظاهرة نصرهم الله تعالى لأنهم قاموا بنصر دينه وَلَيَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ الَّذِينَ إِنْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَحُوا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَلِلَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. So we just translate that. So here he said, the Sheikh, he says, and it was with this strengthening and fortification and stabilization strong determination and seriousness, they held on to all the means of power, implementing Allah's statement. So then here we go on to Allah's statement. And make ready for them who fight you whatever you can of strength and of mounted pickets and frontier, whereby you may frighten the enemy of Allah and your enemy and others besides them whom you know not, but Allah knows them. And whatever you spend in the way of Allah, it shall be paid back to you in full, and you shall not be wronged. So the strength intended in the verse includes both the spiritual and physical strength, having strong faith along with having ammunition. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only helped them because they carried out the responsibility of helping his religion. As he subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us to do in his statement, where we go on, where he said, and certainly Allah will surely help him who helps him, and Allah is indeed powerful and mighty. Those who, if we empower them in the earth, will observe prayer and pay the zakat and enjoy good and forbid evil. And with Allah rests the final issue of all affairs. So that was Surah Hajj. So that, then the Sheikh mentioned, فَفِي حَاتَيْنِ الْآيَتَيْنِ الْكَرِيمَتَيْنِ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ بِنَصْرِ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَعْدًا مُؤَكَّدًا بِمُؤَكَّدَاتِ لَفْظِيَّةٍ وَمَعْنَوِيَّةٍ. أما المؤكدات اللفظية فهي الكسم المقدر لأن التقدير والله لا ينصرن الله من ينصره وكذلك اللام والنون في ولا ينصرن كلاهما يفيد التوكيد. وأما التوكيد المعنوي ففي قوله إن الله لقوي عزيز فهو سبحانه قوي لا يضعف وعزيز لا يذل وكل قوة وعزة تداده ستكون ذلا وضعفا. وفي قوله والله عاقبة الأمور تثبيت للمؤمن عندما يستبعد النصر في نظره لبعض أسبابه عنده فإن عواقب الأمور لله وحده يغير سبحانه ما شاء حسب ما تقتضيه حكمته. وفي هاتين الآيتين بيان الأوصاف التي يستحق بها النصر وهي أوصاف يتحلى بها المؤمن بعد تمكين في الأرض فلا يغريه هذا التمكين بالأشر والبطر والعلو والفساد وإنما يزيده قوة في دين الله وتمسكا به. So he just translated that. The Sheikh, he mentions that in these two ayahs is a promise, in these two noble verses, Allah's promise to grant the victory. So we mentioned that. So we mentioned that here, that in these two ayahs that have preceded, is the noble ayahs. Allah has promised with the victory, whoever aids Allah, and this is a promise that is affirmed in word form and in meaning. And as for in the wording, then it is an oath that is hidden, but it's an oath by where Allah mentions la yansurunna Allah man yansuruhu, that indeed Allah will aid those who aid him. Yeah, and likewise in the Arabic language, the lam and the noon, and this is going into the grammar, that these are وَلَيَنْصُرُنَّ. So the lam here and the noon here, they emphasize the emphasis of that's been mentioned in terms of the wording of the aid that Allah will give. So both of them, they give a benefit of emphasis. And as for the emphasis in meaning, then it is in the Allah's speech where he says, and surely Allah is strong and all powerful. So He's powerful and mighty. The glorified is strong without weakness and mighty without humiliation. And every power or excellence, exultance that confronts with His power and exultance will be weakened and humiliated. And in his statement, وَلِلَّهِ الْآقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ, and unto Allah is the return of affairs, is here. The statement stabilizes the believer and keeps him firm at a time when the believer may have lost hope in being victorious, because he does not have all the means of victory. The believer, however, understands from the words that the final affair is with Allah. He changes what he wants based on his wisdom. So in these two verses, Allah mentions some of the qualities through which victory can be obtained. So these are qualities that the believer has after being established on the earth. So therefore, this authority which Allah gives to a particular person must not be a cause of him being oppressive to others, boastful or arrogant, and a mischief maker. Rather, he should be increasing his strength in Allah's religion. So then, the Sheikh mentioned al-wasf al-awwal. So the first characteristic is the statement of Allah, الَّذِينَ إِمَّكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ. So here is the first category, the characteristic of the people that Allah gives the aid is those who, if we empower them on the earth, will observe the salah, the prayer. Yeah. So وَتَمْكِينُ فِي الْأَرْضِ لَا يُكُونُ إِلَّا بَعْدَ تَحْقِيقِ عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَا يَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. So here, the Sheikh, he mentions, so true empowerment cannot be attained on the earth until, you know, Tawheed is established, as Allah mentions in this ayah that we just read. Allah has promised those among you who believe and do righteous good deeds that He will certainly grant them succession, yeah, the present rulers in the earth, as He granted it to those before them, and that He will grant them the empowerment to practice the religion that which He has chosen for them, meaning Islam, and He will surely give them in exchange a safe security after their fear. Their believers worship me and do not associate anything in worship with me, but whoever disbelieved after this, they are the fasiqun, the rebellious, disobedient to Allah. So yeah. So then the Sheikh, he said, فَإِذَا قَامَ الْعَبْدُ بِعِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ فِي أَقْوَالِهِ وَأَفْعَالِهِ وَإِرَادَتِهِ لَا يُرِيدُ بِهَا إِلَّا وَجْهَ اللَّهِ وَالدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِهَا جَاهًا وَلَا ثَنَاءً مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا مَالًا وَلَا شَيْئًا مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَاسْتَمَرَّ عَلَى هَذِهِ الْعِبَادَةِ الْمُخْلِصَةِ فِي السَّرَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالشِّدَّةِ وَالرَّخَاءِ مكن الله له في الأرض. إذن فالتمكين في الأرض يستلزم وصف سابقا عليه وهو عبادة الله وحده لا شريك له. So here the Sheikh, he mentions here that if a person, he establish his in the worship of Allah. So if he establishes the worship of Allah alone, being sincere to Him in His statements and actions, and seeking with that Allah's pleasure, and seeking the, you know, the abode of the hereafter, he does not seek with it fame and praise from the people, wealth, or anything of the worldly life, and he is to be persistent upon that at times of good and bad, and times of ease and hardship, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will empower him and establish him on the face of the earth. So, so therefore, being empowered on the earth has some characteristics that precedes it and are prerequisites of it, and those are that they are the worship of Allah alone, without ascribing partners with Him, alone with sincerity. This worship must continue after being empowered in the earth as well. So then the Sheikh, he said, well, after being established الحبس السيارتي يكون وث الثاني. So the second characteristics. So the first one was you know, worshipping Allah. Yeah. So it was بعد التمكين establishing sincerity for Allah and worshipping Allah. And then the second characteristic is هو إقامة الصلاة. And that's establishing the prayer. بأن يؤدي الصلاة على وجه المطلوب منه قائما بشروطه وأركانه وواجباته وتمام ذلك قيام مستحب مستحباتها فيحسن الطهور ويقيم الركوع والسجود والقيام والقعود ويحافظ على وقت وعلى جمعة والجماعة ويحافظ على خشوع وهو هدور القلب وسكون الجوارح فإن الخشوع وركوع الصلاة وروح فإن الخشوع روح الصلاة ولبها والصلاة بدون خشوع كالجسم بدون روح وأن so we stop there I will translate so the second characteristic is establishing the prayer by carrying it out in its required manner fulfilling the conditions the pillars and the obligations so we need to know what are the pillars what are the conditions and what are the obligations so that we can fulfill them all and then perform of that performance of that is by fulfilling its recommendations therefore one should perform the wudu in perfect manner likewise one's bowing going into ruku in prostration and standing and sitting all these should be done in a perfect manner and the Muslim should preserve the Friday prayer yeah, in congregation and the congregational prayer as well and maintain his tranquility khushu in his prayer by focusing with his heart and tranquilizing his limbs and this is because tranquility is the spirit of prayer and its core so prayer without tranquility is like a body without a spirit then he mentions وعن عمار بن ياسر رضي الله عنه قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الرجل لا ينصرف وما كتب له إلا أشر صلاته تصؤها ثمنها سبؤها سدسها وخمسها ربعها ثلثها نصها رواه أبو داود والنسائي So he mentioned the hadith of the companion Ammar, so here he mentions that Ammar bin Yasir, may Allah be pleased with him, said, I heard the Messenger of Allah saying, indeed, a man will finish his prayer and only one tenth of it will be written for him, or one eighth, or one seventh, or one sixth, or one fifth, or one fourth, or one third, or half of it, meaning the reward is not fully attained because he doesn't keep, you know, attention with the wajibat, as you said, the obligations, the recommendations, the pillars, you know, the conditions. So that was that. And then that was, so the second characteristic was the prayer, establishing the prayer. The third characteristic is ita zakah, giving zakah. The ayah mentions wa'atu zakah bi'an ya'tuha ila mustahak كيها طيبة بها نفوسها كاملة بدون نقص يبتغون بذلك فضلا من الله ورضوانا فيزكون بذلك أنفسهم ويطهرون أموالهم وينفعون إخوانهم من الفقراء والمساكين وغيرهم من ذوي الحاجات وقد سبق بيان مستحقي الزكاة الواجبة في المجلس السابع عشر. So here the Sheikh he mentions the third characteristic is giving zakat. So the giving the victory is all these. So establishing the worship of Allah alone, praying, establishing the prayer, fulfilling all the obligations, the wajibat, the conditions, the pillars, and you know, doing even everything connected with that, the wudu, you know, having khushu. The second is what? The giving zakat. And that is, you know, wa ita'u zakat, to zakah, give zakah, the Quran ayah, because giving zakah to those who deserve it, giving zakah to those who deserve, being pleased with while giving it, not angry, giving it to them in full without deducting from it, seeking with it the Allah's pleasure and bounty. So the believer, he purifies his soul when he does that. So when you give zakah, you purify soul and you're purifying your wealth as well. And you benefit your brothers who are poor and needy. And we already mentioned the category of this who deserve zakah in the Sheikh mentions in the sitting, the 17th sitting. So if you go back to the 17th sitting, inshallah, you can benefit from that. Who are those who deserve zakah? So then now that was the third. So the fourth characteristic was al-wasl al-rabi al-amr bil ma'ruf wa then the Sheikh mentions wa amaru bil ma'ruf wal ma'ruf kullu ma amara Allah bihi wa rasuluhu min wajibat wa mustahabbat ya'muruna bidhalik ihaa li shar'iyyati Allah wa islahan li ibadihi wa istijlaban li rahmatihi wa ridwanihi فالمؤمن للمؤمن كالبنيان يشد بعضه بعضا فكما أن المؤمن يحب لنفسه أن يكون قائما بطاعة ربه فكذلك يجب أن يحب لإخوانه من قيام بطاعة الله ما يحب لنفسه والأمر بالمعروف عن إيمان عن إيمان وتصديق يستلزم أن يكون الأمر قائما بما يأمر به لأنه يأمر به عن إيمان واقتناء بفائدته وثمراته العاجلة والآجلة. So here the Sheikh he mentions that the fourth characteristic is commanding with good. And then he mentioned the Quran and command with good. So commanding with good is what everything that Allah has commanded with and His Messenger from the obligations and those recommendations the believers are to do. This in order to revive Allah's religion and rectify His slaves' affairs and to seek His mercy and pleasure. This is because the believers to one another are like 45 bricks. Each one strengthens the other. Just as the believer loves for himself to be obedient to his Lord, he should love the same for his brothers. He commands of the good, and the commanding of God must be based on iman, faith, and truthfulness. By implementing that, what he commanded the people with, and being convinced with its benefits and fruits in this world and in the hereafter. And then the Sheikh he mentions al-wasl al-khamis al-nahy al-munkar. So that goes hand in hand with commanding the good, and here now he says forbidding the evil. Wa nahaw an al-munkar, and forbid the evil. Wal-munkar kullu ma naha Allahu anhu wa rasuluhu min al-kaba'ir al-dhunub wa saghairiha mimma yata'allaqu bil-ibadatin aw al-akhlaq aw al-mu'amalatin ينحون عن ذلك كله صيانة لدين الله وحماية لعباده وإتقاء لأسباب الفساد والعقوبة فالأمر بالمعروف. So we stop there. We'll just translate that. So the fifth one is forbidding the evil, which is anything that is Allah and His Messenger forbid of the major and the minor sins regarding any act of worship, characteristic or transactions, and they prevent all these evils in order to preserve Allah's religion, to preserve His slaves, and in order to avoid the causes of corruption and punishment. So then the Sheikh he says, فَالْأَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَالنَّهْيِ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ دَعَامَتَانِ قَوِيَّتَانِ لِبَقَاءِ الْأُمَّةِ وعزتها ووحدتها حتى لا تتفرق بها الأهواء وتشتت بها المسالك. ولذلك كان الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر من فرائض الدين، وعلى كل مسلم ومسلمة مع قدرة. وأنا أمنش الآية: ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. So here the Sheikh mentions commanding the good and forbidding the evil are two strong fundamentals that maintain the Muslims' Ummah's honor and unity, assuring that they will not be divided by the evil desires, and to guarantee that they will not be disseminated in different paths. This is the reason why commanding the good and forbidding the evil is one of the religious duties, which is a must upon every Muslim, man and woman, as long as they have the ability to do it. And Allah says, let there arise out of you a group of people inviting to all that is good, enjoining al-ma'ruf, which is the good, Islamic monotheism and all that is Islam orders to do, and forbidding al-munkar, polytheism and all disbelief and all that Islam forbids, and it is they who are the successful. That is Surah Imran, verse 104. And five. So فلولا أمر بالمعروف ونهي المنكر لتفرق الناس شيئا وتمزق كل ممزق ممزق كل حزب بما لديهم فرحون وبه فضلت هذه الأمة على غيرها كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله وبتركه لعن الذين كفروا من بني إسرائيل على لسان داوود وعيسى بن مريم ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه لبئس ما كانوا يفعلون. So then we'll just translate that. So the Sheikh, he said, had it not been for the commanding with good and forbidding evil, the people would have been divided into groups and sects, each group being proud of what they have. It is with the principle of commanding the good and the forbidding the evil that this nation is given preference over other nations. As he, Allah, the Most High, mentioned in his book, you Muslims upon Islam monotheism and real followers of Prophet Muhammad and his Sunnah are the best of peoples ever raised up from mankind. You enjoy the good Islam monotheism and all that Islam ordains, and you forbid al-munkar, evil, polytheism, disbelief, and all that Islam has forbidden, and you believe in Allah. So then the Sheikh, he mentions, So that is Surah Ma'idah. And is abandoning this foundation that some of the children of Israel were cursed. As the Most High mentioned, those among the children of Israel, who disbelieved were cursed by the tongue of Da'ud and Isa, the son of Maryam. That was because they disobeyed Allah and the messengers and were transgressing beyond bounds. They used not to forbid one another from the munkar, the wrong evil, doing sins and polytheism and disbelief, which they committed. Vile indeed was what they used to do. That's Surah Ma'idah, 78 and 79. So then the Sheikh, he says, فَهَذِهِ الْأَوْسَافَ الْخَمْسَةُ متى تحققت مع القيام بما أرشد الله عليه من الحزم والعزيمة وإعداد القوة الحسية حصل النصر بإذن الله وعد الله لا يخلف الله وعده ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون ظاهرا من الحياة الدنيا وهو عن الآخرة ويعلمون ظاهرا من الحياة الدنيا وهم عن الآخرة هم غافلون فيحصل للأمة من نصر الله ما لم يخطر لهم على بال وإن المؤمنون وإن المؤمنون الواثق بوعد الله لا يعلم أن الأسباب المادية مهما قويت فليست بشيء بالنسبة إلى قوة الله الذي خلقها وأوجدها. افتخرت عاد بقوتها وقالوا من أشد منا قوة؟ فقال الله تعالى: أولم يروا أن الله الذي خلقهم هو أشد منهم قوة وكانوا بآياتنا يجحدون. فأرسلنا عليهم ريحا صرصرا في أيام نحسات لنذيقهم عذاب الخزي في الحياة الدنيا، ولعذاب الآخرة أخزى وهم لا ينصرون. So here the Sheikh he mentioned that these are five characteristics or these are five traits. So he said whoever has these five characteristics are found that they are found in and when among and have strong determination and high ambition, and if they are, these are carried out along with the preparation of the physical power, that the victory will materialize by Allah's permission. This is because Allah does not break his promise, and Allah the Most High said Allah promised and he said Allah promised Allah does not break his promise, but most of mankind will not. And Allah's help for the Ummah occurs in a manner which they may not even perceive. The believer who is sure and certain of Allah's promise must know that the material means of triumph are nothing in comparison to Allah's power, regardless of how mighty these material means may be. After all, who created them and who brought them into existence? So even a person says, oh, someone's got an atomic bomb, Russia's got this, America's that. No. If you got all these five characteristics, the Muslims have them, victory will be ours, regardless of whoever the superpower is or whatever atomic or nuclear or whatever bombs they have. So that person shouldn't give preference to that. So then the Sheikh mentioned the tribe of Ad were boastful of their strength. So they were huge. They said, who is more powerful than us? So Allah the Most High said, as for Ad, they were arrogant in the land without right. And they said, who is mightier than us in strength? See they not that Allah who created them was mightier in strength than them? And they used to deny our ayah, proofs and evidence and verses and revelation. So we sent upon them furious wind in days of evil for them, that we might give them a taste of disgracing torment in this present worldly life. But surely the torment of the hereafter will be more disgracing, and they will never be helped. Surah Fusilat, verse 15 and 16. So then the Sheikh says, وَإِفْتَخَرَ فِرْعَوْنُ بِمُلْكِ مِصْرَ وَأَنْحَارِهِ الَّتِي تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِ فَأَغْرَقَهُ اللَّهُ بِالْمَاءِ الَّذِي كَانَ يَفْتَخِرُ بِمِثْلِهِ وَأَوْرَثَ مُلْكَهُ موسى وقومه وهو الذي في نذر فرعون محين ولا يكاد يبين وافتخرت قريش بعظمتها وجبروتها فخرجوا من ديارهم برؤسائهم وزعمائهم بطرا ورئاء الناس يقولون لا نرجع حتى نقدم بذر فننحر فيها الجزور ونسقي الخمور وتعزف القيان وتسمع بنا العرب فلا يزالون يحابوننا أبدا. فهزموا على يد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه شر حزيمة، وصحبت جثثهم جيفا في قليب بدر، وساروا حديث الناس في الذل والحواري إلى يوم القيامة. And so then we stop there. We'll start a translator and then carry on. So the Pharaoh was boastful of the Egyptian kingdom and the rivers which flow beneath his castle, you know, like the Nile. So as a result, he was drowned in water, similar to the water which he used to boast over. And Allah made Musa, along with his people, inherit the Pharaoh's kingdom, the same one who Pharaoh mocked, yeah, accusing him of being insignificant and not being able to speak clearly because of the speech impediment that Musa alayhi salam had. Likewise, the tribe of Quraysh was boastful of their position and power. They left their homes. Yeah, we mentioned that in the Battle of Badr in a previous lesson, two lessons ago, that they left their homes with the leaders behaving arrogantly and showing off with what they possessed of wealth and power, while saying, "We will not return until we arrive at Badr, slaughter our cattle, drink alcohol, and let our songstresses, the women, sing for us, so that the Arabs will hear about us and will continue to be afraid of us." However, they were defeated severely at the hands of the Prophet and his companions. Their dead corpses were dragged into the river of Badr, and they have become the story of the people today, an example of humiliation until the day of judgment. So then the Sheikh says, وَنَحْنُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فِي هَذِي الْعَصْرِ لَوْ أَخَذْنَا بِأَسْبَابِ النَّصْرِ وَقُمْنَا بِوَاجِبِ دِينِنَا وَكُنَّا قُدْوَةً لَا مُقْتَدِينَ وَلَا مُقْتَدِينَ وَمُتَبَوِّئِينَ لَا أَتْبَاءً لِغَيْرِنَا وأخذنا بوسائل الحرب الأصرية بصدق وإخلاص لنصرنا الله على أعدائنا كما نصر أسلافنا صدق الله وعده ونصر عبده وحزم الأحزاب وحده سنة الله التي قد خلت من قبل ولن تجد لسنة الله تبديلا. So here, the Sheikh he mentions here that if we were to, you know, we as Muslims, that we if we were to hold on to the means of triumph, carry out our religious responsibility, become an example of people who are followed and not the followers of others. So we follow the Quran and Sunnah. We follow the way of the Salaf, the companions of the Tabi'een and At-Tabi'een. We follow the Messenger. We follow that path. We stick to that and not follow the ways of the West. We don't follow the latest fashion. Yeah, we don't follow the latest fad. We don't follow the way they dress. We don't follow the way they speak. We don't follow the way that they behave. We don't follow habits and hobbies. We don't follow them. Rather, we follow the way of the Muslims, and and grasp the modern ammunition of war. So we need to use our brains and use the ammunition. Or like, who invented gunpowder? The Muslims. Who invented, you know, invented a lot of these acts of war? We were the best, you know. So we need to focus on our deen, and also at the same time, you know, try to defend ourselves using the modern ammunitions of war. And if we are honest and sincere, Allah will give us victory over our enemies, as He has granted victory to our ancestors. Allah has indeed fulfilled His promise, aided His slave, and overcome the host. So Allah mentions this is Allah's custom in dealing with those who have preceded, and you will not see any change in Allah's custom. So then the Sheikh he mentioned in the end, Allahumma hiya lana min asbab al-nasri ma bihi nasruna wa izzatuna wa karamatuna wa raf'atu al-islam wa dhul al-kufri wal isyan innaka jawadun karimun karimu wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So that the Sheikh, he says, O Allah, is for us the means of triumph, which will give us victory, dignity, honor, and elevation of al-Islam, and humiliation of disbelief and sin. Verily, you are the most generous, the most kind. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon the Prophet Muhammad, his family members and his companions. With that, inshallah, we finish. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu alayk.